The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in March of 1968 in San Francisco.
Jnanam teham sabhijnanam idam bhakshami ase sata Yadyatya neva bhuya anya jnatabham avasishyate. We have been discussing this verse. What is knowledge? Knowledge means how this universe is working. What is the working force? What is the energy? Just like scientists, they are searching out different energy. Just like this earth is floating on weightlessness. Such a huge mass of material body with so many mountains, so many seas, oceans, skyscraper houses, cities, towns, countries. It is floating just like a swab, cotton swab in the air. So, if one understands how it is floating, that is knowledge. So, Krishna consciousness means to have all kinds of knowledge. Not that we Krishna conscious people are being carried away by some sentiment. No. We have got philosophy, science, theology, ethics, morality, everything. Everything that is required to be known in human form of life. So Krishna says that I will speak to you all about knowledge. So this is Krishna consciousness. A Krishna conscious person should not be fooled. If he is required to explain how these universal planets are floating, how this human body is rotating, how many species of life, how they are being evolved, these are all scientific knowledge, physics, botany, chemistry, astronomy, everything. Therefore Krishna says, yajyatva, if you understand this knowledge, Krishna consciousness, then you will have nothing to know. That means you will have complete knowledge. We are hankering after knowledge, but if we are in knowledge of Krishna consciousness, if we know Krishna, then all knowledge is included. So, tat shakti visaya vivikta swarupa visayakam jnanam. So, we'll have full knowledge about the constitutional position of yourself, this material world, the spiritual world, God, our interrelationship, time, space, everything. There are many things to be known, but the principal thing is that the God, the living entity, time, work, and this material energy. These five things are to be known. You cannot deny that there is no God. God is controller, supreme controller. You cannot say that you are not controlled. There is controller. Just like in the state, you cannot say there is no controller. There is controller. In every street, in every house, there is control, government control. Suppose this store, here is also government control. You have to build store like this. You cannot leave. His residential house, the fire arrangement should be like this. There is control. Even you walk in the street, you drive your car, there is control. Keep to the right. You cannot cross when there is a little stop. You have to stop. So in every way you are under control. So there is a controller. And the supreme controller is Krishna. There is one controller over another controller. If you go on searching out who is the ultimate controller, then you will find Krishna. Sarva karana karana, the Brahma Sangita affirms, Ishvara Parama, the supreme controller is Krishna. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Ishvara means controller. So, we have to get knowledge of this controller, how he is controlling. So, jnanam vijnanati sahitam. Not only to know the controller, but to know how he is controlling. How many energies the controller has got and how he is what controlling. That is vijnanam. So jnanam vijnanam tena sanyukti tubha prapannaya asesata. Now this knowledge can be understood by a person who has made relationship with Krishna and is a surrendered soul. Without being surrendered, it is very difficult to understand the controller and the energy, how he is controlling everything. Shubham prapannaya asesata samagrena upadekshami. This is the condition. You will find in the latter chapters that Krishna says, Naham prakasa sarvasva. Just like if you enter into any educational and institution, if you don't surrender yourself to the rules and regulations of the institution, how you can get advantage of the knowledge imparted by the institution? Everywhere, wherever you want to receive something, you have to be controlled or you have to be surrendered to the rules and regulations. Just like in our class, we are imparting some lessons from the Bhagavad Gita, and if you do not follow the rules and regulations of this class, it is not possible to receive the knowledge. Similarly, the full knowledge of the controller and the process of control can be understood when one is surrendered like Arjuna to Krishna. Unless one is surrendered soul, it is not possible. You always remember that Krishna, Arjuna surrendered himself to Krishna. Shishtasti ham sadhimam prapannam. So therefore Krishna is also speaking to him. Actually, this discussion of scripture is not to be acted unless there is relationship between the speaker and the audience. The audience means the disciples. Disciple means who accept the discipline. Shishya, shishya, the exact Sanskrit word is shishya. Shishya means there is a verb, Sanskrit verb, which is called sas. Sas means control. From sas, the sastra comes. Sastra means controlling books. And from sas, shastra. Shastra means weapons. When the argument fails, reason fails, just like the state controls, first of all, they give you the laws. If you break the laws, if you don't follow the regulation books, means shastra, then next step is shastra. Shastra means weapon. If you don't follow the regulation of the government, keep to the right, then there is police batons, shastra. So you have to be controlled. If you are gentleman, then you be controlled under the instruction of the shastra. And if you are defying, then there is trident of Durgadevi. You have seen Durgadevi picture, trident, threefold misery. You cannot, I have to say, violate any rules and regulations as of the state. Similarly, of the Supreme State, Krishna. It is not possible. Just take for example, there are some health rules. If you eat more, then you will be controlled by some disease. You will have indigestion. And the doctor will advise you not to eat 3 days. So there is control. By nature, nature means God's law, automatically working. Foolish people do not see God's law, but there is God's law. The sun is rising just exactly in the time, the moon is rising exactly in the time, the first year, first January has come exactly in time. So there is control, but foolish people, they do not see it. Everything is controlled. So, to know God and how things are working and how it is being controlled, these things have to be known. We should not go simply by sentiment. Religious sentiment is good for persons who follow blindly. But at the present moment, people are advanced in so-called education. So, Bhagavad Gita gives you full information so that you can accept God with your reason, with your argument, with your knowledge. It is not blind following. Krishna consciousness is not a sentiment. It is backed by knowledge and practical knowledge. Vijnana. Jnanam, vijnana saitam. So, without vijnana saitam. And the process is to understand this knowledge is to be a surrendered soul. Therefore, we disciple. Disciple means one who accepts the discipline. Without accepting discipline, we cannot make any progress. It is not possible. Any field of knowledge, any field of activities, if you want to be aware scientifically and actually, then you should accept the controlling principle. Samagrena Bhakti. Jasarupam sarvakaram jasadhyam tat ubhaya visakam jnanamatvam vaktum. Now, here in this chapter, this is explicitly explained that who is the supreme worshipable object. We are worshipping according to our capacity. We are worshipping somebody. At least we are worshipping our boss. Suppose I work in an office or in a factory, I have to worship the boss. I have to abide by his order. So everyone is worshipping. Now he is the supreme worshipable object, Krishna. How he is supreme worshipable object? That is explained in this chapter. Jatsarupam sarvakaranch jatcha dhiyam tad ubhavisham jnanamattam bhakti pratigyan. Therefore, if we understand that here is the supreme controller, here is the supreme worshipable object, then the problems of our life is solved at once. We are searching after. Just the other day, I told you one story that one Mohammedan devotee, he wanted to serve the greatest. He was serving the Nawab, then he went to the emperor, Barsa, then from emperor to Haridas, a saintly person, and from Haridas he was promoted to worship Krishna in Vrindavan. So, we should be inquisitive, intelligent enough. We are serving everyone, we are serving, at least we are serving our senses. Everyone, practically, they are not serving any boss or any master, they are serving their senses. Suppose if I am serving somebody as my boss, actually I am not serving his money, I am serving his person, I am serving his money. If he says that tomorrow you have to work free, you are getting $20 a day, now tomorrow I have no money, you have to work free, and all knows I am not coming. Because I am not serving you, I am serving your money. So actually we are serving money. And why you are serving money? Because with the money we can satisfy our senses. Without money, we cannot satisfy our these informidable senses. If I want to drink, if I want to enjoy certain such things, then I require money. Therefore, ultimately I am serving my senses. Therefore, Krishna is called Govinda. We ultimately want our sense satisfaction. And Go means sense. Here is the person, Supreme Personality of Godhead. If you serve Krishna, then your senses become satisfied. Therefore his name is Govinda. Actually, we want to serve our senses. But the real senses, the transcendental senses, is Krishna, Govinda. Therefore, bhakti, devotional service, means purifying the senses, to be employed in the service of the supreme pure. The Lord is supreme pure. In the Bhagavad Gita, in the 10th chapter, you will find that Krishna is described by Arjuna, Pavitram Paramam Bhava. You are the supreme pure. So, if we want to serve the senses of the supreme pure, then we have to become pure also. Because without being pure means spiritual. Spiritual life means pure life. And material life means contaminated life. Just like we have got this body, material body, this is impure body. Therefore we suffer from disease, we suffer from old age, we suffer for birth, we suffer for death. And in our actual pure form, spiritual form, there is no such suffering. There is no birth, there is no death, there is no disease, and there is no old age. In the Bhagavad Gita, I have read it, Nitya sāsatayaṁ nahannati hannavāne śarīra. Nitya, although I am the oldest, because I am changing my body, I am as soul, pure, I have no birth, I have no death, but I am simply changing that, therefore I am the oldest. So although I am the oldest, I have got my new spirit. I am always fresh. This is my position. Krishna consciousness or devotional service means purifying these senses. That's all. We haven't got to eradicate, get out of the sensual activity. No. We have simply to purify the senses. How you can get out of the senses? Because you are living entity, the senses are there. But the thing is that at the present moment, because we are materially contaminated, our senses are not getting full enjoyment. This is more scientific. So, devotional service means purifying the senses. Sarvapadhi vinin muktam tatparatena nirmala. Nirmala means purification. How you can purify your senses? That is defined in Narada Bhakti Sutra. It is said that sarvapadhi vinin muktam. Purification of the sense means you have to be free from all kinds of designation. Our life is full of designation. Just like I am thinking I am Indian, I am thinking I am sannyasi, you are thinking you are American, you are thinking man, you are thinking woman, you are thinking white, you are thinking black. So many designations. These are all designations. So, purifying the senses means to purify the designation. And Krishna consciousness means that I am neither Indian, nor European, nor American, nor this, nor that. I am eternally related with Krishna. I am the part and parcel of Krishna. When we are fully convinced that I am part and parcel of Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness and that is purification of your senses. As part and parcel of Krishna, you have to serve Krishna. That is your pleasure. Now we are trying to satisfy our senses, our material senses. When you become, realize yourself that you are part and parcel of Krishna, then you will satisfy the senses of Krishna, Govinda. And by satisfying his senses, your senses will be satisfied. Just like crude example, this is not spiritual. Just like husband is understood as the enjoyer and the wife is considered as the enjoyer. But if the wife satisfies the senses of the husband, his senses are also satisfied. Similarly, just like you have got some itching on the body, and the part of your body, the fingers, itches on that body, the satisfaction also felt by the fingers also. Not that the particular part only is feeling the sensation of satisfaction, but the whole body is feeling this satisfaction. Similar, Krishna being the full, when you satisfy Krishna, sense of Krishna, Govinda, then the satisfaction of the whole universe takes place. This is the sense. Tasmin tushte jagat tushta. The another example is, just like if you satisfy the stomach in your body, then the whole body is satisfied. The stomach will issue such energy by digestion of the foodstuff that it will transform into blood, it will come into the heart, and from the heart it will be diffused all over the body, and all over the body the depression, the exhaustion which has undergone, that will be satisfied. So this is the process of Krishna consciousness. This is the science of Krishna consciousness, and Krishna is explaining personally. So, just gyapta, if we understand the science of Krishna consciousness, then there will be nothing unknown. Everything will be known. It is such a nice thing. Krishna gives you opportunity how you can live peacefully here. But that does not mean that you make your permanent settlement here. Then you are doomed. You take the advantage of Krishna's instruction and prepare yourself so that takta deham punarjanma naiti. After leaving this body, no more coming here. But you go, you transfer to Krishna Loka. We should prepare in that. That is the solution of problem. Otherwise, if you want to live in this material world, this nature is like that. Bhutta, bhutta, pliyate. It is manifested, but at a certain period, again it is destroyed, and there is destroying, and it is a process. So Krishna comes, he sets right everything, but the nature of this world is like that it begins again, literally.